Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. I'm Lewis, and today we'll discuss the patterns to run Microsoft SQL Service for your applications on AWS. I will show you what options you have to run relational database service like Microsoft SQL Service with high availability on AWS. Let's dive in. Before I moved Microsoft SQL Service to AWS, I have a long history of managing relational database in a self-managed environment. This is what it looks like. I need to find a data center that has facilities such as power, cooling, and racks to house my database. I have to provision servers, install operating systems and database software, and manage software patches. There are so many moving components in this process that I'm responsible for. When one of those components doesn't work, it can disrupt my database service. To ensure high availability, I need to find at least another data center and connect two data centers together. I spend lots of time maintaining the network service between data centers to prevent network issues from disrupting continuous database service replication. Many folks share the same experience. When they move database service to AWS, some have chosen to run database service on Amazon EC2. With this option, you no longer need to manage the procurement and lifecycle of hardware facilities. Server rack stack and maintenance will be managed by the team at AWS. You determine the operating system, database software, and the patching levels. You can easily provision database service by deploying the specified Amazon Machine Image, AMI, onto Amazon EC2 instances. Because AWS managed the interconnected network services between the availability zones, there are fewer moving components for you to configure and manage database replication to achieve service high availability. This is a good option if you want to reduce infrastructure level heavy lifting and you want to shift relational database service quickly to AWS. I have also seen some folks chose to move and run Microsoft SQL Service on Amazon Relational Database Service, RDS. With this option, you use Amazon RDS to manage the work involved in setting up a relational database from provisioning the infrastructure capacity to installing OS and database software. Once your database service is up and running, you can select maintenance window to control database service modifications. In your defined maintenance window, Amazon RDS automates common administrative tasks such as performing patching OS, database software, and managing backups. You can configure high availability of your database service by selecting multi-availability zone deployment options. Amazon RDS manages synchronous data replication across availability zones with automatic failover. This option is great because there are even fewer moving components for you to manage. You can further reduce undifferentiated infrastructure and system-level heavy lifting. Now, this is my preferred option, refactoring to purpose-built database. With refactoring to purpose-built database option, you can assess your Microsoft SQL data service compatibility and refactor relational data service to run with Amazon Aurora. You no longer need to purchase Microsoft SQL license to run relational data service. You can focus on optimizing application services and leave data service management to Amazon Aurora. Because Amazon Aurora is fully managed by Amazon Relational Database Service, RDS, you can easily automate time-consuming administrative tasks like hardware provisioning, database setup, patching, and backups. You can further improve database service resilience and scalability by configuring Amazon Aurora with up to 15 low-latency read replicas, point-in-time recovery, continuous backup to Amazon S3, and replication across three availability zones. In this episode, we explored the patterns of running Microsoft SQL Data Service on AWS. We can run Microsoft SQL Service by rehosting on Amazon EC2, replatforming to Amazon RDS, or refactoring to purpose-built databases on Amazon. The automation that these options provide allow you to refocus on business innovation. Check out the links below for more details. See you next time.